With the official standardization of the F-number system in 1990, there was an immediate demand for accurate F-number measurements. This created a new market for test lab services and an educational opportunity for their personnel and their clients.
Right now, we're at the bottom of the learning curve. Everybody's just realizing that it's in the ACI and there's an ASTM test method for it. And there's a lot of people out there that don't know enough about the specification and the test method. And we've incorporated that into our marketing plan where we're educating our clients and hopeful clients in terms of telling them that this is a good quality assurance program, it's a good test method. It's beneficial to both the contractor and the owner in terms of the contractor knowing what kind of quality he's producing to, and he knows that he's meeting the specifications as he's building the project. It's going to be incorporated in the project specifications 100% in the near future. I think almost all architects are going to incorporate this into their specifications.
F-numbers have been used to control the flatness and levelness of tens of millions of square feet of concrete floors. Contractors have learned they can control the F-number results they get.
There are several things that you can control. It's just a matter of learning through experience what to change and when. You can change machine patterns. You can change the timing of the different machining operations, meaning the floating and the troweling. You can change the direction of the re-rod or the re-straightening with the highway straight edges. You can change the method of the initial strike off. There's several things.
One of the reasons a lot of contractors are afraid of the F numbers is the fact they are going to be checked. So many times contractors are used to just going in, getting their wheelbarrow out, getting one machine, throwing the slab in, taking a bull float out, half doing the slab, and then leaving and getting their money for it. One of the reasons they're afraid of it is now they have something to check them. We found that's to our advantage. One, it puts a spirit of competition amongst our boys on the field, the finishers and the carpenters. They're saying, how flat can I get these forms? How close to grade can I get them? The finishers are out there checking, rechecking, double checking, saying, how good can I get the slabs? So we notice a spirit of competition there, which has upgraded our quality, which has given the owner a better product.
I think that we find that the contractors today are willing to listen and want to do better quality work because they see their future in that. If they don't do quality work, sometime down the road, they will be without work. When we started building screeds 15 years ago, one of our objectives was to build flatter, truer floors, and of course the only thing we had to measure it with was a straight edge.
For manufacturers of concrete tools and equipment, F-numbers have meant an opportunity to prove and perfect their products.
We now have a method to measure the flatness of floors, which is directly related to the objective of our business. The F-number system and the advent of the dipstick is probably one of the best innovative things that's happened to the concrete flooring business in the last 40 or 50 years.
For the first time now, we know exactly how flat a floor is or how flat it's likely to be if a contractor uses a given set of installation procedures. This knowledge has helped us to research and develop new products, such as our new flatness-enhancing dry shake surface hardeners. Our customers have always found a direct conflict between flatness and wear resistance. Using a dry shake surface hardener meant that they had to sacrifice some flatness. By using the F numbers, what our laboratories were able to do was research a product, test it, test again and so on, test it against some floors that had a given known flatness, and then continue until they were able to develop a product that could give us a hard, wear-resistant surface and a flatness that we were happy with.
The ability to match construction procedures with the quality of floor they produce has already led to the perfection of revolutionary placement technology, such as the laser screed.
We wanted it to be able to handle low slump. We wanted it to give a tight tolerance. We wanted it to eliminate some men and just make the job easier. And so from that, that's where the screed evolved. And over time, we've been able to use the dipstick to continuously check our work, and as we've made improvements to the screed, we've been able to confirm that they were, in fact, the improvements. And sometimes we've gone the other way also, which it confirms.
F-numbers have replaced all forms of straight-edge specifications and are now an ACI and ASTM standard. Tens of millions of measurements have confirmed that F-numbers realistically portray the flatness and levelness of concrete floors. And contractors who've used the system for years know that by modifying their construction methods, they can control the F-number results they'll achieve. The ACI's new F-number system, already making a difference in the industry, that's easy to see.